أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
والضحى.
By the morning brightness.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والضحى. By the morning brightness.
الليل إذا سجى.
And by the night when it covers with darkness.
والليل إذا سجى. And by the night when it is still and calm.
ما ودعك ربك وما قلى.
Your Lord has not taken leave of you, O Muhammad, nor has he detested you.
ما ودعك ربك وما قلى. Your Lord has not forsaken you, nor is he displeased. Now the oaths, and what is the connection between, what is the muqsam alayh, on what the oath has been taken. Oh Muhammad, you see, there is a difference between night and day. But both are essential. Can anybody say that night is not necessary? This life in this world would cease to exist. Day is also necessary. Night is also necessary. So the coming of day is also necessary. And some pauses and some delays and some cessation is also necessary. So that you develop. Now there is generally people who have some creative role in the world, creative role, who create something new. They have this experience. At times they say, mood off. But what is it, this mood off? Even they can't explain. At times they are very active. At times there is inshirah. And at times it is inqibaz. As if something, you know, has shrunk in your chest. Or as if your chest has widened. These cycles normally go on among the more intelligent people. But you know this cycle, if it remains within certain limits, it's okay. If the amplitude increases, then it is disease, mental disease. Depression and maniac activity going to the top, mania, and this depression. But you know, in the working of this world, you have to have these two. Ghalib says, now I apologize to brothers who don't know Urdu, especially Urdu of Ghalib. Rukti hai meri taba to hoti hai rawa aur. After each cessation, internal cessation, when I come out of that inqibaz or depression, now I have a fresh activity. Enhanced activity, my taba becomes very, you know, active. Rukti hai meri, but there is a time when I feel this, some stop, something has stopped. I can't say poetry. Something has stopped in me. But then suddenly, now when I say, then that is the best poetry. So this is the wisdom of this cessation. This temporary cessation of wahi doesn't mean that your Lord has forsaken you or he has been displeased with you. No, no, no.
And the hereafter is better for you than the first life.
Now these words are also denoting to the same phenomenon. Akhira ula, akhira ula. With every cycle, the coming cycle will be much better for you than the preceding. And the final, the akhira, the hereafter, will be much, much, much more better for you than this world. So it can be, it has been translated in both ways. Every coming moment of your life will be better for you than the preceding one. And the final future, and that is of hereafter, is surely very, very, very much better than this world.
وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى.
And your Lord is going to give you, and you will be satisfied.
وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. And very soon, your Lord will give you all and every good in such an abundance that you shall be well pleased. Don't be disappointed. Continue your struggle. وَلَا تَبْنُمْ تَسْتَقْصِرْ. The same thing. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. And now in three ayat of this surah, three very important features of the life of the Prophet before the start of Wahi.
أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى.
Did he not find you an orphan and give you refuge?
أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى. Look to your past, oh my beloved servant and bondsman. Look to your past. Did he not find you an orphan and then gave you shelter? You were born after the death of your father. First shelter was the mother. Second was the grandfather, Abdul Muttalib. Third was the uncle Zubair. Very few people know that between Abu Talib and Abdul Muttalib, there was the elder son.
وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًا فَهَدَى.
And he found you lost and guided you.
وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًا فَهَدَى. And found you in search of guidance. Dal means someone who is still searching for the guidance, searching for the truth, seeking the truth. Or someone who was on the right path, but by only mistake he has gone wrong. Not due to any bad intentions. In Surah Al-Fatiha we have, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَالضَّالِّينَ. Al-Maghdoobi alayhim are those who due to their bad intentions, they turned to the wrong paths. So they had the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over them. And the most glaring example from among the people of the book are the Jews. But the other were the Christians. Their intention was not wrong. وَرَحْمَانِيَةَ لِبْتَدَعُوهَا مَا كَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ إِلَّا تِغَارِ وَعَنِ اللَّهِ. It was excessive virtue in them. Excessive virtue. That took the form of Rahmaniya. So they are dhalin, not maghdoobi alayhim. So dhal means a person who either by mistake has come on the wrong path, not due to any bad intentions, or he is still searching for the path, for the right way. And dhal in Arabia, this term is applied to person who is in extreme love for someone. وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًا فَهَدَى. And he found you. He was in search of truth. What for? You were going to the cave of Hira, staying there for several nights and days. What for? He didn't belong to any religious group. He was neither born a Jew or a Christian. And you know this idolatry and worship of idols, absolutely it was impossible. Repugnant to him from the very beginning. So what was he doing over there? Intense thought, meditation, contemplation. What is this? What is this universe? Who am I? Where from have I come? Where am I heading? What is wrong? What is correct? And why is this injustice in this world? Oppression? Why this exploitation? Why these inequalities? What? All this thought of a person having a deep philosophical, mind. And at the same time, very intensely right-minded person. What is this? So then we found you searching for the truth and good. And then we guided you and our angel came to you and the revelation started. And number three, chronologically it was prior to this. But this is the rhythm of the surah by which you know the sequence is changed.
وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى
And he found you poor and made you self-sufficient.
وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى And he found you poor, destitute. So he enriched you. From the very beginning he was very poor. Abu Talib was a very poor person. And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to work as a laborer to support him. He was, you know, tending the goats and sheep of Arabs, of the Makki Qarshi people, going out, working hard. And then when he was of some age, then he was working for some rich men as an employee, some rich trader. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the gate for him. The richest woman of Makkah and the noblest woman of Makkah, Khadija, he came to know of the virtues and qualities of Muhammad. He tried him. She tried him. He took a caravan of hers to Syria, came back. And she sent with him a slave of his, most confident, to watch him. See. Is dealing, and the report that she received, then you know she was tempted to offer herself to be married to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Muhammad could never think of it. Many chieftains, you know, of Quraysh had tried to marry her, and she had refused. No. And now, the proposal came from Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. And then Khadija put all her wealth at the disposal of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You spend it wherever you like. I found a story in the Tafsir al-Kabir of Imam Razi that once the Prophet came, he had gone out and they came back, but he was very much sorrowful and grieved, and he lay down taking a blanket something over him. Khadija asked, what's the matter, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He said, I went out from Makkah and in that valley I found there is a tribe who have nothing to eat, no clothing, very poor, destitute people. And I don't have anything with which I can help you, help them. She said, okay, get up and call such and such and such and persons of the Quraysh. Call them. Muhammad went, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, brought them. In the meantime, she had made a heap of the golden coins, so much high that when Muhammad sat behind it, it covered him. And then she said, all of you should be witnesses. I give all this to Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is free to spend it anywhere he likes. وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى He found you destitute, poor, needy. And he made you, enriched you.
فَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرْ
So as for the orphan, do not oppress him.
فَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرْ So now, three commands. As for the orphan, don't oppress him.
وَأَمَّا السَّائِلَ فَلَا تَنْهَرْ
And as for the petitioner, do not repel him.
فَأَمَّا السَّائِلَ فَلَا تَنْهَرْ And as for the beggar or the questioner, سَائِل, two meanings. Somebody comes to ask a question from you. He's also beggar of knowledge. Somebody is asking for some dollars or some money. He is a beggar. But don't be harsh to any questioner, any beggar. Sa'ila falatan.
وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ.
But as for the favor of your Lord, report it.
وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. And as for the blessings of your Lord that have come to you, proclaim them. Announce them publicly. Now this has a vast meaning, you know. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with, you should say, my Allah has blessed me with this thing. My God has blessed me with this thing. That is why the Prophet used to say, although he was very humble, very humble, very humble, no haughtiness ever touched him. Ana sayyidu wulda adam wala fakhr. But he had to say this. Sardar or the chief of all the progeny of Adam. But I am not saying it with fakhr. No. And so on. Nusirtu bil rob. Utitu jawami'ul kalim. And so many things of that type. And the second meaning is that the biggest blessing on you is this Quran. You convey it. Proclaim it from the rooftop. Let it be known to the people. Propagate it. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ.